हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 10th। आवर टॉपिक इज HTML। सो व्हाट आर द ऑब्जेक्टिव्स ऑफ टुडे? व्हाट इज HTML? व्हाट इज अ ब्राउजर? व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय टैग्स? देन द डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ टैग्स लाइक पी टैग, फॉन्ट टैग, हेडिंग टैग, बीआर टैग एंड सेंटर टैग। नाउ स्टार्ट विद इंट्रोडक्शन। सो HTML स्टैंड्स फॉर हाइपर टेक्स्ट मार्कअप लैंग्वेज, अ लैंग्वेज दैट इज हाईलाइटेड दैट आर यूज टू लिंक्स द वेरियस वेब पेजेस एज वी आर यूजिंग द वेबसाइट्स। सो वेबसाइट इज क्रिएटेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ वेब पेजेस, अ लैंग्वेज यूज फॉर क्रिएटिंग अ वेब पेजेस। HTML वॉज क्रिएटेड बाय टिम बर्नर्स-ली इन 1991। इन HTML when we will make a web page we have to use a browser that open our web pages in a software. So come to the question, what is a browser? Browser is a software used to view an HTML document. Example, we can use Mozilla Firefox browser, we can use Opera, we can use Internet Explorer and so on etc. Now when we will use a browser to create HTML document, we have to use the tags. So the question is, what are tags? A tag comprises of the text enclosed in angular brackets. See the example, like we have written HTML in greater than sign and less than sign. So HTML is a text. When we have written this HTML text in this angular bracket, this is make a tag. See, now every tag should have a opening tag and a closing tag. Means when you have to start a tag, you have to close the tag also. Example, like when you will start the HTML document, we will write HTML tag, and when you will close the document, you will close the HTML tag with forward slash. A tag should always be closed with a forward slash. See this slash means we have to put the slash to close our HTML document. Now we will discuss about some basic tags. See, basic tags of HTML. Every HTML document contains four basic tags to make a document. So when we will start our document, firstly we will write HTML. That describes the whole HTML document. This means that we are going to start a document with this tag. Next we are having a head tag. A container of all the head elements, you can say the header section. Next we are having a title tag, describes the title of the document, means where we will write about the web page, which page are going to create today. Next is body tag, that defines the document body, means structure of the document that we are going to create today. Now look at the computer everyone. So, how we will start our notepad to create our document? Click on start button, click on all programs, click on accessories and click on notepad window. So, this our notepad window will appear. So, the first tag that we will write is HTML. After that, we will start the head tag that contain all the head elements. Next we will write the title tag. In the title tag we will write the title of the document, means about the web page that we are going to create. Like here we will write create a web page on pollution. After this, we will close our title tag. And after this, we will close our head tag. Here you can see both tags are closed with the help of forward slash. The next tag that we are going to start is body tag. Means in the body tag, when the body tag will start, all the other tags related to the document, like you want to apply the formatting tag, you want to insert paragraph or any tags, it will come in the body tag only. Clear? Now come to the tags that we will discuss today. So today we will discuss the P tag, then we will discuss the heading tag, then line break tag that is used to break a line, then center tag to align the text in center, and then the font tag to apply the various formatting effects. So we will start with P tag, means the paragraph tag. The full form of P is paragraph. What is the define of this tag? Used to create a new paragraph. The paragraph starts with P tag and end with / and P tag. So to create a paragraph, we will apply some formatting effects also. The first tag we will write then font tag. In the font tag, the first is face. Face means the style of the text. Like when you use the MS Word, we will apply the text style like Algerian, Arial, Times New Roman, Jokerman. This type in the font face, we will specify the style of the font. Next, we are having the font size. That specifies the size of the font, means the size of the text. The maximum size is 7 and the minimum size is 1. But you can choose from 1 till 7. Next, we are having a font color. That specifies the color of the font. Any color you can apply here. Now, look at the computer window, at the monitor. Firstly, we will start with font tag. We will start the angular bracket. Then we will write font. Here, as I have told you, equal to face, then double equal to star. In the double quotes, you will write the style of the text. You can write your text in small letter also and capital letter also. Both work in HTML, means this language is not case sensitive. Means you can write in capital letter also or you can write in small letters also. Both text will work over here. After that, we will write the size. Any size you can give, as I have told you, like 1 till 7, 6, any size you can give. After that, we will write color. Okay, like red. Now the one thing you can see here, you have to write everything like face and size and color in double quotes. And after that, at the end of the tag, when you have start the bracket, you have to close the bracket also. If you will not close the bracket like this, the tag will not work. Means the formatting effects you are going to apply, it will not work. After that, we will start the P tag, means the paragraph tag. Now, here we will use one attribute of paragraph, that is align. Align means the position of the text. Like, if we want to display our heading in the center of the page, so the alignment will be center. Then, angular bracket close means our tag is closed. Then, we will write our normal text, like the heading we want to display in a web page. Now, when you have written the heading, what we will do at the end, we will close the body tag. Then we will close our HTML tag. Now, the other thing we have to, how you can view this web page in HTML, means on the browser. What you have to do, you have to save this document. So what you will do, click on file menu, click on save as option. Now you can see this save as dialog box will appear. Here you have to select the location desktop. In the file name box, you will type your name with extension .html. This extension will identify your document on a web browser. So this extension is very much important. After that, you will click on save button. Now, you will minimize your document. You don't have to close this. You have to minimize your document on the taskbar. See, your document is coming on the taskbar. Now, what you will do? You can double click on your document or you can right click and open your document with any web browser like Google Chrome, Firefox, Internet Explorer. I have opened my document with Internet Explorer. Here you can see on the title bar your title is displayed and your heading of the paragraph is coming on the center of the web page. Now we have to write some information over here. So what we will do? Again we will come back to our document and we will write some lines here about our paragraph. So I have already typed my lines on the pollution topic. I will copy my text and paste in our notepad window. See, these lines are coming. But before this, we will start our paragraph again. Now see, PP tag again. See, the lines are coming in your document. Now again we will see the changes, means that our paragraph is coming on the browser window. So again go to file menu, click on save. But again we don't have to give our name here. Why? Because again we will go to file menu, click on save, but here we will not give again our name. Already we have saved our document, so just we have to save it. We don't give to give the name again. Go to save menu. This document is saved. Now minimize our window. See, our browser window is already there that I have not closed. You can see this refresh button. You can click on this button or you can press the shortcut key like F5. It is coming here. I will click on this button and see, our paragraph is displayed on our browser window. So clear how to create the paragraph. Now look at the notes. The next tag that we are going to discuss is heading tag. Heading tag means you want to write some heading in a document, like you want to write your paragraph name, you want to display the list, like, so for that purpose we are going to use heading tag. Allows us to display the heading size of the text. There are 6 heading levels in HTML, from H1 to H6. The H1 is the highest heading and H2 is the smallest, and so on. H6 is the smallest tag. H6 is the smallest from all the tags. Now look at the monitor. We will open our notepad window. Here, like, there are 5 kinds of pollution of the environment. So how we will discuss the 5 kinds of pollution? We will discuss with heading tag. The first tag that we will write is H1. H1 means what kind of pollution you want to write. Like, we want to write land pollution. Again, if we have start the tag, we will close it also. H1 close. Then H2, we will write soil pollution. All tags, when we will start, we have to close it side by side. Then H3, next heading level, noise pollution. Close H3 tab. Now what will come? H4, we will write air pollution. Close H4 tab. Then start H5. Then we will write water. Close H5. Then H6 is the last heading level. So here we will write industrial pollution. Now close H6 means every tag, when you have start, you have to close it side by side. Now again, what you have to do? Go to file menu, click on save option. You can minimize the screen if required, or you can go to your browser window that is already minimized on the taskbar, and you can click on this refresh button. You can see now all the heading levels are coming. The H1 is the biggest, then H2 is the little smaller, noise pollution, then air pollution and water pollution. And H6 is the smaller from rest of the tags. So this way we have created our heading levels. Now The next tag that we are going to discuss is BR tag. BR tag means break line. When you will insert a new line in our document or in the paragraph, for that purpose you have to use the BR tag. Allows us to start a new line. Now look at the monitor. Here you can see in our web page when we have written the lines, like here full stop is there but the line is not break. If we want to break line at this point, what you will do? We will go to the notepad window, and where you want to break the line, like here. So here we will write the BR tag. See, the BR tag is there. We have only written the tag, but we have not make any changes in the text. So see the browse, click on file menu, click on save. Means every time when you have do the changes, you have to save your document again, only then the changes will appear in the browser window. See, we have not done refresh button, changes are not there, but if we will do the refresh, our line will automatically move to the, see the changes we have made. Now the next step that we are going to discuss, so look at the notes. The next tag that we are going to discuss is center tag. Center means you want to align your text to the center of the page. Allow us to align the text to be centered between left and right margin. Means all text you want to put in the center of the page. See, we have written the tags. By default, it is coming on the left side. But if you want to bring your tag on the center of the page, what we will do? See, we will go to the notepad window. Before H1 tag, we will start our center tag. Here, angular bracket start, center, angular bracket close. You can move this line to the other line, or you can remain it here like center and H1 start, and at the end, when H6 is closed, what you have to do? Close the center tag also. Clear? Now you can see ki here we have started the font tag. So according to this, we have to close our font tag also. So here we have closed our font tag also. Now we have make our text in the center of the page. Again, go to file menu, click on save as. You can press the shortcut key also, that is control S every time. Now go to the browser window and click on refresh button or F5. See, our full heading levels are coming in the center of the page. So today we have created our web page with paragraph tag, that is pollution. Then we have written some lines with the help of P tag. Then to insert the break over here, we have used the BR tag so that our text will move to the next line. Then we have used our heading levels, and to bring all the heading level to the center of the page, which tag we have used? Center tag. So this way we can able to create our web page with the help of HTML document. Now thank you very much.